क्वेश्चन नंबर 4। क्वेश्चन इज द डिमांड ऑफ बुक्स फ्रॉम लाइब्रेरी फ्रॉम मंडे टू फ्राइडे आर गिवन बिलो। टेस्ट द हाइपोथेसिस दैट द डिमांड ऑफ नंबर ऑफ बुक्स डू नॉट डिपेंड अपॉन द डे ऑफ द वीक। सो योर क्वेश्चन इज टेस्ट द हाइपोथेसिस दैट द डिमांड डज नॉट डिपेंड्स ऑन डे ऑफ द वीक। दैट इज अ क्वेश्चन। डिमांड डू नॉट डिपेंड ऑन डे ऑफ द वीक। दैट इज द क्वेश्चन। सो वी हैव टू वेरीफाई दैट। सो हियर लेट अस स्टार्ट स्टेप वन। एच नॉट डिमांड for books does not depend on day of the week, that is each day demand remains same. Each day demand remains same. That is our null hypothesis. No need to write alternative hypothesis in chi-square test 1. Okay. Now step 2, test statistic. In test statistic, we have to first of all find out expected frequency. So how to find out? See here, total demand in the data equal to, just add these 5 values. So it is 100, 200, 300, 400, 500 and 600. So total of this is 30, 40, 60, 70, 80, 90, 80, 600. So total demand equal to 600. Number of days equal to 5. So demand on each day equal to 600 divided by 5, 120. This is our expected frequencies. That is our expectation. Every day demand remains same. That is our expectation. So now you have to prepare one small table, OI, EI. OI means observed values. Observed values are 136, 100, 120, 130, 114. Total of that is 600. What is expectation per day? The answer is 120. That is our expectation per day. That is also 600. Now prepare this column OI minus EI upon OI minus EI the whole square upon EI. Do the calculation. 136 minus 120, that is 16. 16 square, that is 256, divide by 120. So it is 2.13. Now, once again, difference of these two is 20. 20 square is 400 divided by 120. So 3.33. Difference of these two is 0. 0 square is 0. 0 by anything is 0. Difference of these two is 10. 10 square is what? 100. 100 divided by 120. So 0.83. And difference of these two is 6. 6 square is what? 36. 36 divided by 120. So 0.3. Now simply add these numbers. So 0.3 plus 0.83 plus 3.33 plus 2.13. So 6.59 or 6.6. 6.59 or you can write 6.6. So here chi square cal, that is summation of OI minus EI the whole square upon EI, I running from 1 to n. So total of that is 6.6. So chi square cal is 6.6. That is the answer for the question chi square 6.6. But we have to complete this question. So here you have to write degree of freedom. V equal to how many days are there? How many values are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 minus 1, sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 minus 1, 4 is the degree of freedom. Now here one thing you require to verify before calculating chi square, that all the expected frequencies should be more than 5. All the expected frequencies should be at least 5. All the expected frequencies should be at least 5. If any of the expected frequency is less than 5, in that case we have to do something extra that we will discuss later on when we have that type of situation. Okay, now degree of freedom 4. Now step 3. Alpha, if nothing is given, let us take 5%. Step 4. F at alpha equal to 5%. Degree of freedom V equal to 4. From chi square table, we get chi square tab equal to, so for that what we require to do, we have to use table. See, this is chi square table and here our alpha equal to 5%, 0.05, and degree of freedom is 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So the value is 9.488, means 9.5. So you can consider as 9.488 means 9.5. Or better to write 9.49. So this is our chi square tab. Now step 5. In step 5, it's better to draw the chi square curve. It should be like this. See, it is like this. And our tabulated value is 9.49. So this is our rejection area and remaining is the acceptance area. And here our chi square cal is 6.6. So it should be here. Chi square cal is 6.6. This is chi square tab. So we can say that our chi square kel is in acceptance area. So H naught is accepted. Therefore, H naught is, because this is acceptance area. This is rejection area. So H naught is accepted. Better word is not rejected. That is loosely H naught is accepted. And if H naught is accepted, that means there is no significant difference between observed frequencies and expected frequency. That is, demand does not depends on day of the week. So all day demand remains same. So that is our final conclusion. Any problem to anybody? Any problem to anybody?
No, sir.
Okay, let us continue. Question number 5, you can consider as homework, but let us discuss that one. A die is thrown 150 times and the following results obtained. Now, if we throw a die 150 times, we get 19 times 1, 23 times 2, 28 times 3, 17 times 4, 32 times 5, and 31 times 6. So if we throw the die, maybe we get either 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if we repeat that for 150 times, we get number of times 1, number of times 2, number of times 3, like that, and we have that data. And the question is, states the hypothesis that the die is unbiased. We want to check whether die is biased or unbiased. Means die is perfect or not. Unbiased means die is perfect. Means there is no evidence that any one particular number occur more times than the other one. That is the meaning of unbiasedness. Means die is fair, perfect. So if die is perfect, then out of 150 times, we get how many times 1? Any of you? This is your observed frequency. What is your expected frequency? Any of you, if die is perfect?
25.
Once again?
25, but I think the
word. Correct, 25. How to get 25? Each number occurs same number of times. So that is your expected frequency, and then you have to do the remaining work. So it is simple question. Let us do this question number 6. In an experiment of pre-bidding, the following frequencies of sheets were obtained. Round and yellow this much, wrinkle and yellow this much, round and green this much, wrinkle and green this much. Total 560 is there. Theory predicted that the frequency should be in the proportion of 9:3:3:1. Are the data consistent with the theory at 5% level of significance? So theory indicate there should be this proportion for this four type of situation. 9:3:3:1, this is the proportion. So this is our what? Observed frequency. And what is our expected frequency, any of you? We know that total should be 560. So how to obtain this expected frequency?
Then 315 into 9 divided by 6, divided by 16.
Correct. See, what is total of this? Total of that is 16. So 9, that is the first value, divided by 16 into total 560. So that is your expected frequency. Similarly, 3 divided by 16 into 160. Then 3 divided by 16 into 560, sorry, not 160. And 1 divided by 16 into 560. So we get expected frequencies. And once we have expected frequency, what we have to do? You have to find out OI minus EI the whole square upon EI. And this is the way to solve this type of question. Same way. So consider this is homework. What is your null hypothesis here? The proportion is 9:3:1. That is your null hypothesis. And remaining part is very simple. Let us do this question. 7. Genetic theory state that children having one parent of blood group M and other blood group N will always one of three type M, MN, N, and that the proportion of this type would be 1:2:1. So this is the proportion of blood group among the child. Now what is the question? A report states that out of 300 children having one M parents and one N parents, 30% were found to be of type M, 45 MN, and remaining N. Test the hypothesis by chi-square. So this is also a very simple question. Let us do that. This question, very simple question. Question number 7. Null hypothesis. Step 1, null hypothesis. You would write the proportion of this is proportion of three types M, MN, N. Proportion of three types will be 1:2:1. So that is your null hypothesis. Proportion of three types of blood group M, MN, N is 1:2:1. So this is the null hypothesis. Now step 2. Under H naught, better to prepare table. Now see, we have a information that a report state that 300 children having one M parents and one N, 30% were found to be M type. So out of 300, 30%, that means 90 are of M type. Then 45% is MN type. So 45% of 300. 45% of 300 is 135. That is MN type. And remaining, total what we have? 300. So 300 minus 135 minus 90. So 75. Once again, this is percentage of 300. How much percent? It is given in the question. 30%, 45% and remaining. So see, you can see that 30 plus 45, that is 75%. So remaining N type are 75%. 25%. So 25% of 300 is 75. Now what is our expectation? So our expectation is this. So what is total of this? 4. So you can calculate like this, 1 by 4 into 300, that is 75. Then 2 by 4 into 300, that is 150. Then 1 by 4 into 300, that is once again 75. So this is our expected frequency. Now OI minus EI the whole square upon EI. See, no one expected frequency is less than 5. So just calculate without doing anything extra work. So now 90 minus 75, that is 15. 15 square is 225. 225 divided by 75, that is 3. Now 135 minus 150, that is what? 15. 15 square is 225. So 225 divided by 150. So it is 1.5. And 75 minus 75 is 0. 0 square is 0. 0 divided by anything is 0. So total of this is 4.5. So chi square cal is 4.5. That is the answer. Now let us complete remaining procedure. Here chi square cal is sigma I equal to 1 to n OI minus EI the whole square upon EI, the total of that is 4.5. And degree of freedom, so here there are three values, 3, 1.5 and 0. So these are three values. So 3 minus 1, 2 is the degree of freedom. Okay, step 3, alpha 5%. Step 4, at alpha 5%, degree of freedom 2, chi square tab. If you want to write in symbol, you can write like this, chi square degree of freedom is 0.05, alpha is 0.05 and degree of freedom 2. So 0.05 and 2, if you see in table, 0.05 and 2, the answer is 5.991. So 5.991. Step 5. Chi square tab 5.991. This is our rejection area. And calculated value is 4.5. So 4.5 should be here. So H naught is accepted. H naught is not rejected. That means accepted. That is, H naught is accepted. Loosely speaking, better word is not rejected. So we can say that H naught is accepted. That is proportion 1:2:1 is correct. So that is our method to check this type of hypothesis. Let us discuss this question. Question number 8. The following figure shows the distribution of digits in telephone directory. By taking 10,000 digits randomly, we found that 0 occur 1026 times, 1 occur 1101 times, 2 occur 997 times, like that. Test the hypothesis, test at 5% level of significance, digits may be taken occur equally frequency in the directory. So digits are occur equally frequency. That is the question. We have to test that thing. So this is what, whatever the given thing, that is what observe. Okay, any of you know how to find out expected? Expected frequency. How to find out expected frequency? What is the hypothesis we have to check? All digits occur equally frequency. All digits, 1, 2, all occur same proportion. So how can you find out that thing? Be fast. be fast. Any of you? रोल नंबर 115
सर एवरेज लेनी होगी शायद.
हाँ
एवरेज लेनी होगी.
हाँ एवरेज यानी हर नंबर सेम नंबर ऑफ टाइम्स आना चाहिए. दैट मींस आउट ऑफ 10,000 ईच नंबर अकर 1,000 टाइम्स. सो 1,000 1,000 1,000 1,000 1,000 दैट इज योर एक्सपेक्टेड फ्रीक्वेंसी. ओके कंसीडर दिस as homework. Homework means your assignment. Listen carefully. Homework means your assignment. You have to submit your assignment. You have to solve the question. You have to make the PDF file and you have to submit in our group. That is considered as the assignment. There is no any exam like normal exam. So be careful about that. Okay, let us do question number 9. Very important question. A sample of 200 families, each having 3 children, give the following distribution of boys. Test the hypothesis that the boys and girls are equally probable. Boys and girls are equally probable, that is the question. So, see, after studying 200 families, all 200 families having 3 children, all 200 families having 3 children. But after studying 200 families having 3 children in each family, we found that there are 40 families in which all are girls, no boy, all 3 girls. There are 60 families in which one boy is there and 2 girls are there. 62 families having 2 boys and 1 girl, and 38 families having 3 boys. Now the question is, check boys and girls are equally probable or not. That is the question. So this is our observed frequency regarding number of boys 0, 1, 2, 3. This is observed frequency. And how to find out expected frequency? Any of you? This is most important question. So now what you require to do, this is you consider as your main homework. We will discuss this in next lecture, how to obtain expected frequency. This is very good question. Try to find out the answer of this in our next lecture. But it is I will give you the hint here. For this, first of all, we have to find out probability for getting zero. If there are 10 digits and if all are occur equally frequently, then what is probability for getting 0? The answer is 1 upon 10. What is probability for getting 1? Answer is 1 upon 10. Why 1 upon 10? There are 10 digits and 0 occur if all digits occur equally frequently. So probability for all is 1 upon 10. And then after we have to multiply it by total. So if we multiply by 10,000, so we get 1,000. So 1,000 is your expected frequency. 1,000, 1,000, 1,000 is your expected frequency. How to obtain this 1,000? This probability into number of observation, you will get the expected frequency. So that is the logic you have to apply for this question also. So try to find out the answer for expected frequency in question number 9. And remaining all are the homework. We will discuss question number 9 in detail in our next lecture. So this is enough for today. Any of you have any doubt, you can ask your doubt.